Hi, this is Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day. I've been asked now by a couple of people, how do I take close-ups of plants and insects using a camera like the FZ200? In this video I want to demonstrate some of the techniques I use to enable me to capture the images that I do with such cameras. If you use the camera at its wide angle position, so you can use the closest focus distances, you end up with a tremendous depth of field, and that's inherent because of the 2/3 inch size of the sensor. With such a small size of sensor, the camera gives a very large depth of field, and that can work against you if you want to throw the backgrounds out of focus. It's alright if you want to show the plant and animal in its environment, you can actually use that to your advantage and show the whole of the vista in complete sharpness. But if you just want to isolate that plant against its background, you have to come up with some creative ways of doing that. In this video, I want to show you the ways that I do that. The first technique I use is one with the camera set to its widest angle and going close to the plant to show its natural environment, such as the illustration I'm showing you now of this primrose. The camera is just set to its widest angle position and I've got close and focused on the plant, and by the inherent depth of field it's showing you everything in the background pin sharp as well. In contrast to that, have a look at this picture now, which I took from the 600mm end of the lens. It allows me to isolate the plant against its background and you can see more detail of the plant. You can use this camera at about 2 metres at 600mm and get this sort of picture. The subject height is about 6 inches high. If you need to be closer, then you may need to use supplementary lenses to enable the camera to focus at these closer working distances. The number one is the least of the diopter range, and that allows you to use the camera almost up to infinity. The number two is a little bit stronger and you're limited to something like 2 meters away, and if you use the number four you can get fairly close and still maintain the distance you need. With the number four lens you can get even closer, but the camera will then start to suffer from chromatic aberrations, as these lenses aren't designed really with the bridge camera in mind. They're intended for a 55mm lens on an SLR, so we're pushing the optical technology a little bit too far using it with a bridge camera. But nevertheless, if you just want the central area of interest, these lenses will give you that close-up distance. Have a look at these red berries. The first shot was taken with the wide angle setting and you can see the berries are nicely in focus, but also is the background. Contrast that to the second shot here, where I've moved back, set the camera up to 600mm, and you can see the berries are still nice and sharp and the background is nicely defocused. So that's one of the techniques I will use to isolate plants a bit against the background. You can autofocus using the autofocus macro mode. If you press the little button on the side of the camera, it will then allow you to set the size of the target for focus. Set that to the smallest size that the camera will give you, and then you can actually pinpoint your focus and use exposure lock if you need to allow you to recompose the subject. You can also use the manual focus mode, and if you do that, I would advise you switching over the zoom lever on the side to the focus mode. You can actually set the function 3 button on the camera to allow you to change the side lever from zoom to focus just by pressing one simple button. It's quicker than going through the menus to get to the setting for the zoom lever. It does allow you to manually focus, and you can rack focus the camera in and out of focus, but what I found it's best to do is to roughly focus where you want to be and then move the camera backwards and forwards. So if you focus where you need to be and then just position the camera forwards and backwards, observing the focal point, and then take it when you're in maximum sharpness. That technique works best with macro subjects as well, as it does allow you to actually see your actual plane of focus before you press the shutter button. If you can, shoot at ISO 100. That's why I tend to use a tripod for most of the shots, because some of the exposures can be a 60th of a second or less, and if you're using the 600mm telephoto end, you really do need to be quite stable for that. Shoot in RAW if you can, and you can either process those images with SilkyPix or you can use Adobe Lightroom 4.2. If you ever thought that coming out into the countryside would give you a nice quiet environment to do the filming, think again. We've had the guy with the strimmer over there, we've had the micro light aeroplane, And now we've got the 747 coming into Manchester. So that's some of the problems trying to create your own videos in a natural environment. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks very much for watching. And as usual, if you don't already subscribe to the channel, please consider doing so. So until next time, it's Graham saying thanks again for watching. I hope to see you in the next video. Bye for now.